I am fucked up right now. I'm very cold. I am shaking right now. I just feel like absolute dog doodle. My brain is like, my heart's beating faster than normal. It sucks. Makes me want to break the fast. Oh my God. I feel terrible. I tried eating zero calories, drinking nothing but water, fasting for 72 hours. 3 days. Let's see what happens. All right, so this is my starting physique right here. This is flexed, unflexed from the side, and then flexed from the side. So clearly I'm not like super fat. I'm not obese or anything, but I am starting at 17.2% body fat. I'd like to get down to 15. And then my waist size is 33.75 inches. And the goal is to get down to 31 or 30 inches. So this is 16 hours fasted.
All right, so we are currently at 24 hours of the 72-hour water fast, which means we got 2 more days. That's crazy to say. It's crazy to think. Like, you say 72 hours is whatever. You say 3 days of not eating? My God. So I'm kind of hungry. I think my body just wants food. I feel just, like, I low-key feel depressed because I haven't eaten in a whole day. I'm not that hungry, to be honest. I'm just like very low mood, low energy. They say the first 24 hours are the worst, but we got the first 24 out the way. So we'll see in the morning how I'm feeling. Hopefully I feel better. I really don't want to have to take any supplements or energy or caffeine or anything like that. But just want to update y'all on how I'm feeling. I will see you in the morning. Good morning with your crusty ass. It's the next morning. As you can see, I look like dog shit. I will say I'm very tired. No energy. Extremely tired. Don't feel like doing anything. It hurts to move. I got up and brushed my teeth. I'm exhausted. At 36 hours or 37 hours, whatever I'm at, no hunger. 24 hours last night? Ugh. But we're at 36 hours. I feel not hungry whatsoever. Like I said, the first 24 hours is the hardest. So, we got the boulder at the top of the hill, baby. Now we just gotta push that bitch down and it's smooth sailing from here. So, I'm about to go to the gym, give you all a physique check. A whole day and a half until I can eat again. That's crazy. But yeah, we finna hit the gym, so I'm gonna see y'all there. Peace.
See that mistletoe right there? Let me just come give Poppy a kiss. Alright, so I was about to not hit the gym completely just because I really have zero energy, but what I'm about to do is I'm about to take this. It's for energy and focus. I'm about to take one of these tablets, and then I'm about to have some sparkling water. Hopefully, this shit gives me energy. They said that sparkling water with zero calories, zero carbs, zero sugar, it actually doesn't break your fast. So, I'm going to have a little bit of that. I probably won't even drink the whole thing. I just feel like absolute dog dookie, so I'm about to have that. Go weigh myself and then go to the gym. All right, that's what I'm going to do. No energy. All right, let me catch y'all later.
Hi, little mama. We at the gym, baby. Look, I got some more energy. I'm going to be honest. I got some energy now. I'm still kind of tired, but I got energy at the same time. It doesn't make sense. But I will say this. I don't know if it's from the tablet or it's just because I'm outside and I just needed to get out the fucking house. Maybe that's what it was. Bing bong. So right now we about to have this sparkling water. Hey, y'all let me know if this is breaking the rules. I really didn't set any rules except for no calories. And it's technically no calories. Y'all let me know if this is cheating or not. If I should do the whole thing over again and have nothing but water. But I did have the tablet. This is technically not breaking the fast. There's no sugar, no calories. So I'm finna have that. I'm finna have like a couple sips. I did weigh myself. I'm 171 and a half. And the first time I weighed myself before I started, I was like 173 and a half. So I lost 2 pounds in a day and a half. So we got another day and a half, and then we'll see if I gain weight or if I lose weight, continue losing weight. Maybe this might make me gain weight. Who knows? Actually, let me give y'all my reaction because I haven't had any flavor in over a day and a half. So let me give y'all my reaction. Here we go. This shit tastes like toilet water. Oh God, this is not good. Oh, let me try another one. I'd rather just drink straight water, my guy. It's not even an energy drink either. It's just water. Ah! Yuck! All right, let's get this workout, baby!
36-hour physique check. All right, so this is right after I went into the gym. When I recorded this video, showed the physique off. Clearly, there's a lot less bloating. I feel pretty light. And yeah, I clean up pretty much most of the toxins in my body. Clearly, still got some work to do, but that's it.
Just left the gym. Bro, I need to whiten my teeth because goddamn. Anyways, just left the gym. I think I have more energy than I had in the gym right now. I didn't do a lot. I didn't. I stretched for 5 minutes, walked on a treadmill for 10 minutes, burned like 55 calories. I usually burn about 120 to 150 on a treadmill in 10 minutes. So performance was low. To be honest, the energy levels are at an all-time low. After the gym, I went inside of Publix and I picked up a Bang energy drink. I looked at it, zero calories, zero sugar, zero carbs, and I was this close to buying it. Thank God I didn't have my wallet on me, or else I would have purchased that beverage. I did do my research. It will not break your fast, but the worst thing that it can do is actually, it can make you crave food, because tasting something sweet, your body is thinking that you're gonna put some food in it and get some nutrients, and in reality, it really doesn't have any nutrients in it. The worst part about all of this is I'm not even really hungry. The biggest thing is I just miss food so much. Like, honestly, the emotions I'm feeling is kind of just like sadness, loneliness, the fear of missing out. Like, I'm just thinking about all the different foods I could be eating. Right now, I'm in this plaza. You got Chinese food, Jersey Mike's subs. You got ice cream over there, man. God damn it. When I was in the gym, I was just listening to this video. This guy was talking about how video games are a symptom of childhood trauma or video game addiction. And I realized I had a video game addiction and definitely a food eating addiction. And that's the thing I struggle with most this year. It's just eating so much food whenever I felt stressed out or like I wasn't doing what I needed to be doing in life. I would just always resort to food. So that right there, just realizing that is a big motivating factor, because I kind of want to get rid of my food addiction, my binge eating addiction. Like, I'm not really fat. This year, I definitely got the fattest I've ever gotten. I gained probably 20 pounds this year. I've never gained more than maybe 10 pounds in a single year in my adult life. The highest I got to was like 180. And I just weighed myself again. I'm still the same weight. I'm 171 and a half right now. And I'm trying to get down to 160 by the beginning of next year. Like I said, the hardest part of this whole thing is just missing food. And if I distract myself from that, I think I'll be good. Like I said, I'm not hungry at all. I mean, maybe a tiny bit just because I'm thinking about food and talking about food. So right now I'm about to go find something to do in my town, because normal activities, I can't even do them, because if I do some work today on my business, I'm probably just gonna get stressed out by it. And then it's gonna make me wanna eat even more. So I'm finna go find something to do in my town, and then I will catch up with y'all when I get there. Peace. I don't know what event is going on today. It is an event. All I seen on Facebook was there's gonna be like holiday desserts and baking goods and, you know, like cookies and cakes and stuff like that. So we gonna find out what's going on over there. It's gonna be pretty nice. Bunch of old white folks out here. It's gonna be some good vibes. I wanted to LA, hoping to explore. Alright, so that thing that was going on downtown, I didn't realize what that was. It was called a flea market. I've never been to a flea market in my life. I've heard of them, never been to one. Decided not to go back to my car. I walked over to this park, which is probably half a mile from my car. Get my steps in today. Finna just sit here in nature,
chill at his park, maybe do some pull-up hangs, just hang on the pull-up bar to improve my grip strength so I can do more pull-ups. But besides that, not really much eventful things going on. I'll probably update you guys when I officially, at 6:30, when I officially hit 48 hours, which is 2 days. 2 days does not seem like a big milestone. I feel like I'm so far from my goal. A whole day left, man. A whole day, 30 more hours. But we're past the halfway mark, so we're like 42, 43 hours. I'm not hungry. And also, if I decide to drink a Bang energy drink, I'll let you guys know. Like I said, it's not breaking the fast, but it's important that I let y'all know that. Finna get this nature, and then I'll see y'all later. It is currently 3:00 in the afternoon, 3:20 to be exact. In 10 minutes, I'm about to hit hour 45. Damn, I look rough. That's okay. We finna have a glow up in 2022. You just wait on it. I have decided that I am going to go buy a Bang energy. At this point, I don't really give a shh. I got a whole entire day left. We're almost 2/3 of the way there. Day number 2 is almost finished. It will be finished in 3 hours. And then I'll have 1 day left and I can have a nice ass dinner. So I'm about to go get a Bang energy. Let's go pick out a flavor. Got that Bang energy, baby. I decided to get the pina colada. I do want to let me just preface this right here. Some people are going to be talking shit about this. I just want to preface this in the video right here real quick. So a lot of people are going to be saying, oh, water fasts are a waste of time. You're going to lose all this weight, then you're going to gain it back, blah, blah, blah. But let me just say this real quick as I can, okay? So I started out at, let's say, 173 and a half. Let's say I finished out 170 or 167. So I lost 6 pounds, okay? If I lose 6 pounds, I am probably going to gain that 6 pounds back. But listen to this. Well, my voice is cracked. I'm going through puberty. Listen to this, okay? I will gain weight back, but you have to understand there's a difference between weight and fat. So you can gain 1 pound of weight, but not gain any fat. All you have to understand is there are 3,500 calories in 1 pound of fat, okay? My calorie maintenance is 2,500 calories. If I fast for 3 days and eat 0 calories, that means I burned 7,500 calories, which is almost 2 pounds of fat. That fat that I lose is gone, okay? So after this fast, if I go back to normally eating, I'm gonna gain back all the weight, but those 2 pounds that I lost are gone. You understand that? Those 2 pounds of fat are gone. The fat is gone. I'm going to gain weight, but it's water weight. It's water. Water comes and goes. It goes in your body, it goes out your body. In your body, out your body. Have you ever used the bathroom before? Then you understand that water goes in your body, out your body. Have you ever sweated before? I'm sweating right now. Anyway, that's all I wanted to say. I got a pina colada. Y'all about to watch me taste this. This is technically the first thing that I'm tasting in 2 days. Besides that weak ass, fake ass LaCroix. Let me go outside, actually. Let's drink this shit. Oh my God, hold on. Oh my God. I don't even want to finish. That's all the taste that I needed. Did y'all see that? I barely sipped it. I just sipped the like little juice that goes on the top. Oh my God. Hold on. I'm about to have like a food high right now. That was amazing. Holy shit. That was life changing. Holy cow. I kind of just got like a head high from that. Oh man. Damn, this low-key feels like cheating. All right, if you tell me that I'm not allowed to do something, it's only gonna make me wanna do it even more. Even if I tell myself, I say you can't eat for 3 days, I just wanna just go out and go to a fucking buffet just because there's the proof that I can do whatever you say I can't do. I know it's, sometimes it can be a toxic mentality, sometimes it can be a successful mentality. I don't know, but that's just the type of mindset that I have. I didn't wanna give up the challenge just because I couldn't taste anything. Like I said, I'm not hungry. I just have like that depressing feeling of like, I'm not allowed to do what I want to do. Anyways, let's do a full sip. That shit was crazy. My God. My God. Who made this? Who made this? That shit is amazing. I gotta sit down. Whew. 0 calories per can. Remember that.
Alright, so after that amazing life-changing experience, shit only went downhill from here.
Y'all,
I am fucked up right now. It has been close to an hour since I drank the Bang energy drink. I'm very cold. I am shaking right now. It's like when you drink alcohol on an empty stomach. That's how I feel, except for I'm not drunk. I just feel like absolute dog doo-doo. My brain is like, just feels wired. My heart's beating faster than normal. It's like how it would be beating if I was doing a brisk walk, but I've been sitting down for like 40 minutes. This sucks. Makes me want to break the fast, finish a challenge, but I gotta keep going. So I'm gonna just chug some water. That's gonna make me pee out whatever I drink. Oh my God. I feel terrible. I'll update y'all later. I drank some water. I left the house, quit being a little bitch, and I was fine. It is 60 and a half hours. Less than 12 hours left, baby. I woke up at like 6:30 and I tried to go back to sleep, but my body wasn't having it. I usually wake up that early, but I wanted to wake up when I had like 10 hours left, but it is what it is, baby. I'm gonna go weigh myself, give y'all the physique check, and then hit the gym. I wanna see how much I weigh. I wanna make sure I hit 165 just to say I did it, you feel me? 65-hour physique check. Not much has changed. I look a little bit lighter. Maybe the bloating has gone down a little bit more, dropped a little bit more water weight, but I wasn't drinking a lot of water just so I can hit that 165. And later in the video, you'll see why that's not a great idea. I was pretty dehydrated in the gym. I only did like 10 minutes of cardio, and I got the fuck out of there.
Was good, y'all. I just left the gym. Weighed myself before the gym. When I woke up, I was 168. Just had my gym session. I just want to say, bro, I was struggling hard on the elliptical. And I realized the reason why I was struggling was because I'm actually dehydrated. It's not because I don't have energy or anything like that. I think it's because I'm dehydrated. And I think the reason why I'm dehydrated is because I was so focused on the numbers. Like, I want to make sure I hit that 165. And if the less water I drink, the more likely I'm gonna be to hit that number. But after realizing that, man, it's not worth it, bro. I really don't care how low the number gets now. So like I said, I weighed myself, I was 168 this morning. So that might be the lowest that I'll get during this challenge. So even though I got like 8 hours left or whatever, still in 8 hours and not eating food, I might gain weight just from all the water weight I gained, but at this point, it's not even worth it. That's it. I'm tired. It's the last physique check of the day. It's 3:30. We got 3 more hours. All right? 3 more hours. I'm not going to do a physique check at 72 hours just because, I mean, I'm not going to look any much different. And I'm too tired, so I'm probably going to go in the house, take a nap, wake up, and eat some food. It's physique now. Flex. That's final. Mouth is bitch.
Hi.
After that, I couldn't really handle it anymore, so I broke the fast. Psych, baby, we made it! 72 hours, baby. I'm officially done with this fucking video. I'm officially done with this fucking challenge. I'm about to eat my fucking oatmeal. I'm tired of this BS, bro. I'm tired of bullshit, bro. Miserable. 72 hours. All right. My starting weight was 173 and a half. My finishing weight was 168. My starting waistline was 33.75 inches. My finishing waistline, let's measure right now. 33 and a half. Finishing waistline, 33 and a half. I promise you, I just measured it. I mean, 32 and a half, my bad. Finishing waistline, 32 and a half. I lost an 1.25 inches, 5.5 pounds. I'm done with this bullshit. I'm about to eat my oatmeal. Bye.
Later that night.
You know what fucking time it is? A specialty chicken fucking combo, baby. Poppy, I've been waiting for this for 3 fucking days, okay? You get the motherfucking Domino's cheese slice. Put a little bit of drizzle of ranch on it. Put the motherfucking specialty chicken on it. Put a little bit of ranch and barbecue sauce on top of that. Get another slice. Put a little bit of drizzle of ranch on it. Slap that bitch on top. Mm. I seen this in my dream, okay? You gotta try it. Pick that bitch up and eat it like a sandwich. Oh my god. I've been waiting 2.5 days for this. You ready? Oh god!
Subscribe or else.